Hello everyone, Carl here, and welcome back to Aeronautica. What we have here is the Lockheed WP-3 Orion, which is a weather reconnaissance multi-engine. It's a yellow rarity. And if you want the statistics for this plane, it's right over here. It has the maximum speed of 328 knots and a average capacity of 15. This is only one of two storm chaser planes. The other is the Lockheed C-130H Hercules. And it's the green rarity plane in Clarence, which has better performance in altitude, but it doesn't really help much because it's not a factor in this kind of job here. So the new job here is the weather hunting through storm number 26. The objective is to fly your aircraft into the mentioned storm, collect weather data, and return safely to Rawaki International. It says here that you need to fly into the mentioned storm, meaning you shouldn't go above it because that's... It says into that. It's explicit. Into the storm. And collect weather data, then after that, return safely to the starting airport that you took off. And let's begin. Alright. And it says that the creator of this game had modeled this plane over here. And the storm should be right over there. So let's turn on the engines. And oh, I forgot to increase the sound. Volume, rather. Well, the sound of this multi-engine is like some other multi-engines, so you might have heard the same. So let's increase the throttle to 10% or more. And let's take off at runway 27. Nope, that's a bit fast there. Reduced to number 7%. And a safety precaution to we going back to this airport. Turn on the runway. And just good at multitasking, that is. Alright, so storm is over there, it's not that far, it's in the range of this aircraft. If we calculate twice of that, it'll be able to go back and land as intended. Though, that means a water crash. Mm-hmm. Let's align. Alright. So let's start taking off. And let's see if we can do the passenger view. Oh, it's, the camera's too low. Of course it is. So I can't take a takeoff position like this, so let's do the usual side. Like this. Oh, I didn't know that. Alright, let's just take off in this manner. So what you've been seeing is that I immediately turn to port towards the direction of the storm cloud. So we'll stay around 3,000 or 4,000 meters above the sea just to get inside the storm. It's 99 kilometers away. So, where is this direction? 10 minutes. That's enough. Let's first begin with going at cruising speed, and then we'll descend into the storm, just to be safe. So let's go a bit up to cruising altitude, and once we get close to the storm, we will descend. A bit. Alright, I can see the storm clouds right now, so let's go into the storm. That is, we have to, lower our altitude. Get into the frying pan. Oh, that's a bit steep. So around 4,500 meters above is fine. Looks like we're going in. And there's cloud cover here, some obstruction. We'll compensate when we get through. There we go. So let's This is low enough. Still clear, but we're going to change to foggy once we get in. And full speed ahead. Oh, more obstruction. No matter. There we go. All right. 3,000 meters is enough. And that's it. There we go. In a few moments, this will change to rain. Slide to the right. And it's about to get dark. Let's turn on the navigational lights. Thank you. Looks like we're going in. I miss, but it's not. It's not so. Yeah. It doesn't affect the flight so much. Directly into the guide point. This part of the job is just similar to the tour. That means you'll have to reach the waypoint like so. Got a nasty storm, so let's get away from it immediately. you've heard right now is thunder. And you saw some lightning strikes. Well, we're back to the rain. And we're just going to head to this waypoint over here, so let's start. Yeah, that's a beautiful storm. Alright, we have succeeded in hunting the storm, or storm chasing, that is. And it's time to return to Roblox International, so let's head for cruising altitude and start landing when we're there. So, and that's that. That's how you chase a storm. It's like the tour that you have to follow the orange arrows, and you might see a storm, stormy weather, happening with all the thunder and lightning. But that's just part of the natural weather. And that's that. We'll see on the next video, or if you want to continue, you can just continue watching and see this plane land at Rawaki, and you're welcome to. Alright then, thanks for watching.